Alright, so... don't be surprised if I start collecting all of my old games complete in box, because the boxes look so cool. Like... we already saw these credits. The music is really good, though, yeah. Look how sweet this box looks, dude! Oh, man, it's cool. Okay. The biggest Game Boy adventure yet. It does, yeah, it does flex. And then the back is pretty modest. Just the sky blue. Really crappy looking screenshots. It includes battery backup. Alright, alright. Let's pop it open. Yeah. I'm being careful, don't worry. Well, I didn't throw the boxes away. My parents probably did. All right. Let's take a look here. Oh, man. Look at that. If Nintendo, please focus. There we go. All right, I better change the stream title real quick to say that we're playing, Mario Land 2. All right, there we go. Champa, he won the NXT title? Nice. I'm doing my best here. Okay, this stuff has to go over here. All right, here we go. Danger. Oh, look at this. Look at this asshole. This guy is a fucking douchebag. Look at him. Oh, man. All right. While I was away crusading against the... is this written in the perspective of Mario? While I was away crusading? Oh, dirty nails? Yeah, there's like blood under this nail. I kind of screwed it up. And then my other nails might be kind of dirty too. I'm sorry. I don't know when I slammed this finger, but it got kind of bloody underneath my fingernail. While I was away crusading against the mystery alien Tatanga in Sarasa Land, an evil creep took over my castle and put the people of Mario Land under his control with a magic spell. This intruder goes by the name of Wario. He has been jealous of my popularity ever since we were boys and has tried to steal my castle many times. It seems he's succeeded this time. Wario has scattered the 6 golden coins from my castle all over. That's weird. Okay, it's time to set out on our mission. Look at this Mario. Look how great he looks. And then... oh, those are the 6 golden coins. Yeah, alright. Cool. Mario Land. Wait, is this continuing? Oh, Wario... I thought it was... Wario has scattered the 6 golden coins from my castle all over. And then I didn't realize that there wasn't a period. It's all over Mario Land. These golden coins are guarded by those under Wario's spell. Without these coins, we can't get into the castle to deal with Wario. We must collect the 6 coins, attack Wario in the castle, and save everybody. Oh, he's bouncing off a thing. All right. Look at that Game Boy. Nice. I know, it's weird that it's Mario's castle and it's in Mario Land. Like, that's bizarre. Super Mario. Oh, so if Mario... if Mario picks up a mushroom, he will transform into Super Mario. Weird. That's true, Flex. I'm very curious about that, too. Like, the fact that it's in Mario's first person Mario is, like, really weird, and it's, like, not... It's not, like, fun. It's not written very, like, fun at all, you know? Fire Mario. Beware, some enemies cannot be destroyed by fireballs. Bunny Mario. And then hold down the A button. Okay. That's gonna be important. Invincible Mario. Aqua Mario. He's just swimming! When I get into a lake, do I become Aqua Dash? Space Mario. Oh, this is the good stuff. Please focus, because this is the good stuff. Let's go. Let's go! There it is. Battle Beetle. Grubby. Don't tread on this grub. Skeleton Bee. Oh, man. Noco Bombette. Look at this! Toady! Boppin' Toady! Spiky. Oh, he looks like, he looks like the Hans Molman of the Sonic the Hedgehog universe. Oh, man. Crow, they're not even like that anymore. Games nowadays just don't have anything in them. They put the tutorial in the game in an annoying way, usually. All right. Yeah. We don't need really all this stuff. We'll figure this stuff out. I'm really just here for the artwork. Oh, yeah. Look at that. The Mario Land map. This is Mario Land. Cool. Macro Zone. Mario Zone, right! I really enjoy that area. All right. Well, there we go. That was the instruction booklet. Yeah. One-handed. Ugh. And there's our game. All right. Let's get to the playing part. Does it flex? We'll find out. I did my best with the transition. Oh, right, camera. All right, there we go. You know what, Niner? It's funny. Like, if I made videos about video games instead of just streaming, I feel like getting the shots of putting the game in would be, like, the most fun part. Editing together quick cuts of insertion and stuff seems like it would be really fun. Now let's go, file A. Oh my gosh, that's right. Super Game Boy, why do you do this? Why does it default to type B? I feel like there's gotta be a way to save. Alright, well. The sprites are certainly a lot bigger in this game. Goombas are just as big as... Wait a second, that's normal. for Goombas to be just as big as small Mario, isn't it? I never really realized it until it was like this. Whoa, that was snappy. Whoop. One of your top five Game Boy games? I'm curious as to what the other four are. My favorite Game Boy games would probably be... I don't know. Operation C is pretty sweet. Oh, right, you ring the bell as a checkpoint. Okay, five dudes gets you a... Because this game doesn't have score in it. You guys, that is interesting. So... Oh, and Kirby's Dream Land would probably be another favorite. Okay, right, you press down in the air to do a spin jump. Anyway. I'd say, like, Kirby's Dream Land and Operation C are probably my favorite Game Boy games. I honestly haven't played a ton of different Game Boy games. Oh, and I don't know. It's funny because, like, a lot of the games that come to mind if I think about favorite Game Boy games are, like, Metroid 2 and, like, Pokemon. But, like, those aren't even games that I super love. But yeah, there's no score, which... Okay, so... Oh, nice, I got something. Oh yeah, Link's Awakening is great. That's a big one, for sure. But yeah, it's funny that, like, for some reason, Metroid comes to mind, even though I don't really love Metroid 2. But, like, as far as Game Boy goes, it's a pretty cool game. There's so many things to interact with. you had the Game Boy Color. My first Game Boy was a big one. The old DMG. Big and stupid is what my brother if you hold up, do you jump higher? Yes, you do. Still not high enough to get through here though. Look how cute these things are. I don't remember these in the book though. And then I had a yellow Game Boy Color later. And then... So I had a DMG Game Boy. Then Flex got a Game Boy Pocket. And then I got a yellow Game Boy Color. And then after that, we both bought Game Boy Advance SPs. But at that point, we were buying them, you know. The Game Boys that we had before then were from our parents, but we actually purchased the... Oh, nice! That worked out. We actually purchased the Game Boy Advance SPs. These... are probably a big level that a big thing that everybody remembers are these levels with the goop and the cowfish. Yeah, I'm a pretty big sucker for handhelds. So once I started purchasing my own hardware, you know, I got the Game Boy Advance SP. I bought the DS launch day. I skipped the DS Lite, but I got the DSi when that came out, which was kind of a mistake. Then I skipped the DSi XL, and I got the 3DS when that came out. And then I got the 3DS XL. And now I have a new 2DS XL. Because it's a new 2DS XL. And it's modded for game capture. And then meanwhile I had a PSP and I have a Vita. So I love handhelds. This level's like really creative and stuff, but it's exactly what I remember about this game, which is slow and easy. Ooh! Well, I fell into some spikes there. Yeah, I wouldn't say very many of my favorite games are handheld. Like, maybe some of them. I have a feeling you... Oops. Yeah, I died. I have a feeling that you can't jump on the, horned beetles. Oops. Welcome back, Amber. So one thing that's funny about... Oh, you can't buffer jumps. One thing that's funny about the Game Boy Advance, though, is that I think that... Oh, you can just jump on them. Is that I'm really glad I got the Game Boy Advance SP and not the Game Boy Advance when I was younger, because the SP is so great. But... If I were to get a Game Boy Advance now in order to play the Game Boy Player with, I would probably get a regular Game Boy Advance. Because I don't want to worry about the battery. Which is funny because the battery was such a huge selling point for me when I was younger. It was such a big deal when I was younger that the Game Boy Advance SP had a rechargeable battery. But now, if I'm streaming, I would rather just be using double A's and not have to worry about having to stop because my Game Boy needs to charge. And the reason that it would be an issue is that... Oops! Oh, they Kaizo'd me. The reason it would be an issue is, you can't use the Game Boy Advance to GameCube cable, and the charger at the same time for the SP. Oh yeah, I forgot why you even left, Amber. Right, it was the poop. Link's Awakening, Mega Man 3, Donkey Kong, and Final Fantasy Legends. Well, that's only four games. Oh, and this one. Right. Does that happen to dogs with their strict diet? We're doing all levels. Hey, there's the grub. I'd rather have firepower than bunny ears. Maybe it's just the Mario 3 talking. Whoops. I like how these coin blocks are laid out so, like, interestingly. Because you're in, like, a honeycomb. Or a hive, you know? Hey, Red Panda. Thanks for the welcome back. He went three times. Oh, no. Oh, you can't jump on those guys, those big, ugly ones. Yeah, Mega Man wasn't one that I considered. I played a lot of Mega Man 2 on Game Boy when I was a kid. And that was the only one we had. Wait, I've got a lot of coins. Do you like... What do you do with coins in this game? There must be something to do with them, since we have, like, so many. Yeah, I remember, Mega Man... Oh, the people food. It's always the people food that gets them. Yeah, Mega Man 2 also had two sets of bosses. And I Flex was telling me that it's like, because I don't remember, and I never played the NES ones when I was a kid, so I'm not going to remember now also, but Flex was telling me that it's like the first four bosses are from the NES Mega Man 2, and then the next four bosses are from the NES Mega Man 3, or something like that. I shouldn't put words in his mouth because that might not be what he said. And he might not even, you know, might not even be sure of it. But there might be something like that. Oh, see, now what you're saying, though, that makes it sound like that is exactly what it is. Is this gonna make me normal? Oh my gosh, it does! I don't even want the bonuses anymore, if that's what it does. But you do it, you have the chance to get, 3 1-ups if you get the crane game. Flying Goombas. Oops. That's a good rule to have. Oh my gosh. The Mario is so slippery. This is some nostalgic music too. Do you think I could have just jumped straight over that first gap? Oh, no! Yeah, my first Mega Man game was Mega Man 2 on Game Boy. But I haven't played a ton of Mega Man. Besides that, I've only played Mega Man X, which I loved, played a ton of it. And then I've played Mega Man 1. I played Mega Man 1 on NES. A little bit of 2 on NES. Flex and I played... Well, no, we played Rockman 2 on Famicom, sorry. So I've played that one a little bit. And then a little bit of Mega Man 9. I don't remember what system I played it on, but it doesn't really matter. But I liked it. I thought Mega Man 9 was pretty great. Oh, okay. I love the overall sound of the Game Boy. Like, this music sounds a lot like the Picross music, but it's because it's using, like, the same sounds, you know? Oh, no! Hey, Casco. Mega Man's pretty hard. The last book I read? Devastating. I don't read books very much. Is this gonna that's just gonna straight bunny me, huh? So the last book that I read... I gotta think about that for a long time. Okay, I'm loving this guy. Hang on, I seem to remember this being the easiest boss ever. Like, you just kind of do this thing. Oh, mighty number 9. Okay, that was the easiest boss I've ever seen. Look how sweet this door looks, though. Whoever designed this door was working on a different video game. I love how it's got the Koopa on the right and the Goomba on the left, though, if you're facing from the door. Alright, we conquered Tree Land. Oh! Okay, let's give this a test. Ah, this is what you use. Okay. Alright, and we got the witch. We got the old cunt. Okay. Alright, well, we gotta know what- I'm going straight for 999s. Love it. Turtle zone, let's go. But yeah, oh man, Mighty Number 9 was a disaster. There were so many things wrong with that game that weren't just the game was bad. Like, just the fact that it was like, okay, we want... What did they want for that game? You know, $300,000 or whatever? And then they got, like... And then they got, like, $3 million or $20 million or some ridiculous amount of money. They got a crazy amount of money. Way more than they asked for. But then they got a publisher? And it's like, wait a second. The reason that you get something crowdfunded is because a publisher is not giving you money. But now you do have a publisher and it's Deep Silver? Those shitbags? Oh no. And then they started another Kickstarter for another game while that one was still being worked on. And an anime. And then, oh yeah, and then the special edition! Right, it was like, you could get a special, like, original NES box, or Famicom box, but no matter which one you got the same instruction booklet. So the instruction booklet only fit in one of the boxes. So if you got the Famicom box, your instruction booklet just didn't fit in it. Oh man. Who's Deep Silver? They're just a shitty publisher that publishes shitty games. And has found themselves in controversial positions pretty often. Like they published Dead Island. I think. They were the company that, they published, Ride to Hell Retribution, I think. I'm, like, almost sure they published Ride to Hell Retribution. They published the later Saints Row games. THQ published the first three. And then Deep Silver bought Saints Row when THQ was being bought out. And so they only produced like Saints Row 4 and that kind of stuff. home front. Yep, yep. Well, Homefront was another THQ thing, where the original Homefront was THQ, and they did Homefront, whatever it was. What was it called? The recent one that was, like, really, really terrible. Not that the first Homefront was great. I never played it, but from what I understand, it was nothing special. Homefront Revolution, that's it, yeah. And yeah, anything post Saints Row the Third would have been Deep Silver. So yes, if that's... So yeah. Anyway, the point is that Mighty No. 9 crowdfunded way more money than they asked for, and then they got a publisher anyway. Which is just one of the many, many things about that Kickstarter. My favorite thing, though, is probably the fact that they kickstarted a second game in the middle of it. And then, you know, what I remember, too, is I think really the big issue was stretch goals. The fact, and I think, personally, I think if you're going to crowdfund something, you should be very, very, very modest and realistic with your stretch goals. I feel like that's a huge issue where it was like, Mighty No. 9, we want, you know, we want this much money. Oh, we're getting $300 million? Okay, this is gonna be the biggest game ever now, you know? It's gonna be on every system. It's gonna have online co-op, you know, and like all that kind of stuff. And you read that, you read like, wait a second, this small indie studio that was trying to make a little Mega Man style game is now promising this kind of stuff, and it's like, that's not gonna happen. Just because they got the money, you know, doesn't mean that they can just do that. And of course, boom, the scope of the project gets so big that they can't deliver on it. So, stretch goals... Yeah, stretch goals should be much more realistic than that kind of stuff. Oh no, these things can't be fired. You're excused, Amber. I have, in fact, on stream, Flex and I played through the whole game once. Now, isn't it just like a lot of the same level? Isn't it a lot of the same levels as, Donkey Kong Country, but like shortened? Yeah, this game's got really creative levels, for sure. I want to save Mario Land for just a little later. Let's go to Halloween Land. Oh, Donkey Kong Land. Oh, you're just talking about Donkey Kong for Game Boy. No, I've never played that. I've only played Donkey Kong Land. Pumpkin Land? I forgot about this place. Oh my gosh. I watched Reanimator last night with Daisy and the rest of the Retro Dino Disco crew. I gotta tell you guys, this movie was amazing. It was, for sure, like without a doubt, one of my new favorite movies. Thank you. Yes, Reanimator. That's what it was called, right? Yeah, yeah. Oh man, it was so good. Holy shit, it was good. Of all the movies that we've been watching, my favorites have been Reanimator, The Thing, and then probably 976 Evil, and Wishmaster. I would say those are my four favorites. Dead Alive is up there too. Dead Alive is probably like number five after those four. That movie was really good. It might even be better than that. It, like that whole scene where he's got the baby outside, I was just dying. That part was so good. Yeah, Nina, that scene is really, really good. And just like the fact that they bring the doctor back to life, and oh my gosh, I just collected this and it hurt me. They bring the dad back to life. Because the corpse that he has to bone saw kills the dad. And so they bring the dad back to life. Oh, it's so good. Sharknado? I've heard of Sharknado. I got another life too. Okay, hang on though. It's fine. I don't want the goal anyway. Or I don't want the bell. Oh yeah. That part was weird. My internet was kind of acting up. So I saw that part in about one frame every 10 seconds. That was weird, and I was not expecting it. But it's just like, it's such an interesting concept. Here's something I love about Reanimator. Is that so many movies... I feel like if Reanimator came out now, or if it was remade or something like that, they would have to spend an hour explaining how he came up with the serum, you know? How he made it, and all that kind of stuff. And that's dumb, boring, doesn't need to be in the movie, you know? Nah, in Reanimator, he already has it. And it's about... It's about him testing it. And it's really great because it's like... It's good to... He's trying to save lives. But like, in order to research it, it's like this super, like, unethical, crazy... human experimentation that it takes to prove that it works and to get data on it and that kind of stuff. Dr. West is just like so dedicated to it and stuff. And yeah, you're right. Because your perspective is of the main character and not that doctor's, exactly. You don't get to see all that kind of stuff. It's like, right. It's just like, he's this crazy guy who's got this serum, and it's so good. Yeah, I'm talking about Reanimator. We watched it last night? And I'm just gushing about it because I fucking loved it. And it's funny, Flex saw that movie forever ago. Flex has been telling me that that movie's great forever. But yeah, I've never been interested in Sharknado because it's one of those movies where, like... Well, I don't know. It might be entertaining. I'm not sure how much I'm into the movies that try to be like that. Yeah, the one with Jeffrey Combs. Yep. Boop. Mario got a broomstick right up the butt. Oh, okay. Well, he... We'll spare him from that one. I love these, like, what are these enemies? Jason hockey masks with knives in them? An X-rated version, what, of what movie? Oh, if it's a Reanimator, I don't know. I imagine that one really weird scene we were talking about probably just maybe goes on a little longer. Oh, there we go. Okay, that is just what you do. Oops. Oh! I jumped right up into that. Yeah, with the disembodied head. Yes, Flex. Okay. I gotta say... When I was watching Reanimator, I was sitting there thinking... This is literally the best movie I've ever seen. Until the reanimated head and body started becoming like a character. Like when he cuts the guy's head off with the shovel, I was like, fuck yes, this is continuing to be the best movie ever. And then he reanimates the head and the head like opens its eyes. And I was like, yes. But then the head, like, became a character. And I just gotta think about it a little bit. Because on one hand, that's great, you know? On one hand, it is fantastic that there is the disembodied head and body character bumbling around. That's kind of great. But at the same time... I feel like it might... I don't know. I feel like it might have been more interesting... if the head couldn't breathe or talk because it's just a head. But I don't know where the movie would have gone if that happened. You know, I did it again. I guess I don't have to stand on the middle pot. I don't know where the movie would have gone if that didn't happen, though, you know? So it is kind of great. The fact that it starts conspiring with the lobotomized dad doctor and stuff, like, all that stuff is all great. So, yeah, you know, it was great. Like I said, it was still one of my favorites that we've watched. I also really, really liked Nightmare on Elm Street 3. Even though I had a pretty violent reaction to one of the gore scenes in it. Yeah, okay, so I haven't seen Evil Dead, but we did watch Evil Dead 2 and Army of Darkness. We watched Army of Darkness just because it's like, you gotta see Army of Darkness. And then it was like, oh, Army of Darkness was great, let's watch Evil Dead 2. And then and we did, and it was great. I have not seen Evil Dead 1 yet. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know about Sharknado just because it's like it's made to be stupid. I don't know exactly I don't know exact like how interested I am in a movie that's just made to be stupid. Oh, okay. All right. So what are you saying? You are on the edge. I definitely remember somebody named On the Edge. However, Twitch does let you change your username. I've changed my Twitch username. On the Edge, you might remember me as super_retro_bros. But the account is now called Dash Retro. Because you can change your username on Twitch. So I am a tad concerned. Of what you're saying here. Alright, we got her that time. I stopped holding in run. And that way I wasn't jumping too high. Swing! Used to be Amber 1777. Were you born on July 7th, 1777? Abigail LaFay? That is LaFay, right? Yeah. Alright, let's go to Hippo Land. Oh! Yeah, this place. Oh, January 7th, 1777. Oh. Yes, that is a King Diamond reference. Oh my god, Death Rider! So, my TV that I play games on, right up here. I've got a King Diamond, figure. Oh my god, Red Panda, I have actually seen Transmorphers. I know it's really surprising, because I have never seen any movies ever, but I have seen Transmorphers. It was bad. About, 80 minutes into the movie, my friend who I was watching it with turns to me and says, "I don't think this is Transformers." And we had a good laugh. That was the best part of the movie. That was better than anything that happened in the movie. My favorite part of the movie, though, was when they had to, like, drill into one of the aliens or something. There was, like, a scene where it was like, here's the alien, and they were, like, on a table, and they were, like, drilling it. Maybe it was a robot or a transmorpher. But they were clearly, not only were they clearly just using a drill that they had spray-painted silver, but they took the battery out of the drill. The drill didn't have a battery in it, and they didn't spray paint the inside. It looked like they spray painted it with the battery on, and then took the battery off. So when the camera showed the bottom of the drill, you could just see the red plastic from it. Well, I guess we're in Space Zone now. Oops. trans boy for the for like the gender that it's made for. Well, are you a trans boy? Because if so, that's perfect. I'm glad you found the costume that you needed. I'm glad you had options. Oh, it was a costume of a trans boy. All right, gotcha. You know, my best... I think my best costume ever when I was a kid. The best costume that I ever came up with was a picketer, or like a boycotter. I said it was a protester, and then everybody was like, "You're a picketer!" I'm like, "I don't know what a picketer is, I'm a little boy, I know what protesters are." And, And I, you know, I was pretty proud of the costume. I wore like a flannel shirt, like jacket kind of thing, you know, and sweatpants and stuff. Like, I looked like I was ready to be outside for a long time. And I had a sign to hold up. And the sign, because I was a little boy, what do little boys have to protest about? My sign was to boycott Snickers. Because there were too many nuts in the Snickers bars. Boycott Snickers. Too many nuts. That was my costume. I was proud of it. And then at school that year, in elementary school, all the kids wore their costumes to school. And all the teachers were like, they didn't believe that I thought of the costume myself. Because I guess it was more creative than little boys are allowed to be. But that's why I was proud of it. Yeah, I mean, I just don't like Snickers. That's the real thing, is that I just don't like Snickers bars. And why don't I like Snickers bars? Because I don't like nuts in my candy bars. So that was as far as it went, you know? That was as far as the thought process went, as far as what the sign was gonna say. Because really, it was just about, oh, you can just fly in this level. Okay, it's like Balloon Fight. Oh, you've got the old, your router sends out two different SSIDs for the channels. Makes sense. That reminds me of a network issue I had once where, I configured a network for, what is it? 802.1 AC? Wireless? And, they were complaining that they didn't have 802.1 AC access? And it was a big fight we had for a long time because I did everything right. And then, I'm only realizing now how terrible and tedious this story was. But the problem was that they had not configured their machines to recognize the AC signal. So it wasn't my fault. Oh god, that story was terrible. Remind me to never talk about work on stream again. Except for Thursday, when I was on the phone with Verizon for 4 hours trying to get our internet circuit to work and they couldn't figure out why it didn't work. And I don't mean I was on hold. I do not mean that I was on hold for 3 hours and then talked to somebody for 1 hour. I mean that there were dudes on the phone actively working on this thing for 4 hours and they couldn't figure it out. Oops. Well, I mean, they weren't blaming me or anything. They just didn't know why it didn't work. Well, okay. Alright. Here was the frustrating part. They kept telling me to use their DNS servers instead of mine. When all I was doing was trying to ping across the circuit. As in, my IP address was x.x.x.x/30, and their IP address was x.x.x.x/30. Only one other IP address on the range. This was mine, that was theirs. Point-to-point link. Two things connected to each other. I was just trying to ping across the one hop, right? Pinging their IP address specifically. DNS has literally nothing to do with this process. There is no DNS lookup. DNS is not configured for this process. It has nothing to do with it. And they brought it up like 5 times to try their DNS servers. And I'm like, I'm gonna freak out if you bring up the DNS thing again. Because it has literally nothing to do with what we're doing right now. So, that's how Thursday went. But, Crow, you were one of the members of Motionless in White for Halloween one year? Oh, man. Every time that band comes up, we learn a little bit more about just how much Silent Crow loves them. The only time that I've been, like, a musical artist for Halloween is I was Schaefer the Dark Lord for Halloween one year, but that was really only because I already looked like him. Like, my hair was his length, and I just was wearing a purple shirt and tie and a black tie. And I just I happened to just kind of look like him. Oh, wait! Never mind! I was also Mike Patton for Halloween one year. Young Mike Patton. And I went and sang Faith No More songs at a rock band party as young Mike Patton, and it was great. Again, though, that was also a time where it was because I just kind of already looked like him at that time in my life. How did that hit me? There we go. I'm really glad that you put the parenthetical every time that the song Loud, Fuck It comes up. I'm really glad that you write it out every time. Thought you were Shrek. Those people are just straight up morons. And that's all there is to it. I dressed up as Link for Halloween one year. That was the first, that was my first video game character costume that I made myself. Like, there were a few years in a row where I kind of got into, like, really doing a costume. And the first one was Link. Like, you know, I bought a really big green polo-y, golf-y kind of shirt thing and like, made the necessary cuts and sews to make it look like a tunic on someone of my size. I took like a leather backpack and like cut the straps up and stuff to make like the sword and shield harness. My mom sewed the hat out of fleece for me. I made a master sword and a Hylian shield out of wood and spray painted them. And the shield turned out really well. I made templates and just like template spray painted it. And then I dyed my hair blonde for that costume. And I was Link, and it turned out really well, I thought. I even wore that costume to school a few times, because then I had this entire Link costume that, like, that I just had, you know? And so I was like, I'm just gonna wear this thing sometimes. And so every once in a while, I just wore it to school for no reason. I'm not really sure what the point of that level was, except to power me up. I definitely did the vampire and ninja thing, but those were like store-bought costumes. The Link thing I was really proud of because I made it myself. The year after that, I was the merchant from Resident Evil 4. Oh wait, there's more about the Link costume. So the Link costume, I mentioned I dyed my hair blonde for the costume. And, I dyed my hair blonde for the costume. But I didn't like having blonde hair. So shortly after was the first time that I ever shaved my head bald. Was to get rid of my Link hair. Yep, and then the next year, I was the merchant from Resident Evil 4 for Halloween. I bought a black trench coat. This costume was easier. I just bought a black trench coat, which I ended up loving, and I wore that black trench coat every day, for years to come after this costume. I loved that coat. I still have it upstairs. I don't wear it anymore. I should start wearing that thing again. It's awesome. I grew just a little bit, though, so it doesn't, like, go down to my ankles anymore. I want a trench coat that goes down to my ankles, you know? Anyway, got a black trench coat. Only problem was that the trench coat didn't have a hood, so I had to, like, take a big piece of black cloth and kind of, like, just drape it over my head and then stuff it into the collar to kind of look like a hood a little bit. And then, got a blue, white speckly piece of fabric and just kind of fashioned that into a little mask, you know, like the merchant wears. And then, I got a bunch of images, you know, like the ammo boxes and stuff in RE4? I got images of all the ammo boxes and printed them out and taped them onto some just pieces of cardboard so that when I opened my coat, I could have, like, the different ammos. Even though the merchant didn't sell ammo, but shh. And also, I took a can of spray paint, or some kind of spray, and I printed out a first aid spray label and put it on that. And boom! I had a merchant costume. It was great. I think the year after that, I was Leon from Resident Evil 4 for Halloween. The problem with the Leon haircut was that, I got my hair cut in the Leon style, but, like, it didn't turn out super great. Like, just the back looked a little funny, and I didn't really know that the back looked very funny. And then I just kept that haircut for a really long time, because it wasn't like the Link thing where I just didn't like it. I liked how it looked on the front. So then I had, the merchant doesn't sell first aid sprays? Are you sure? I think the merchant sells first aid sprays. And I think that they're 10,000 PTAs. But anyway. I don't really remember about costumes after that. I remember being Scully for Halloween one year because Flex was Mulder. My Scully costume was pretty half-assed and last minute and not very good. But when it was me and Flex together, you could tell what it was supposed to be. However, the funny thing, though, was that I saw a picture from that night. A long time later, I saw a picture of me in the Scully costume. And I was sitting there going, like, why am I dressed like that? And then it took me a minute to go, oh, it was Halloween. What was my costume? It was really funny. I couldn't tell. And then one day, like, randomly, Flex brought up the Mulder and Scully costumes. Or I think I asked him about it or something. I don't know. He remembered that it was Scully. We're climbing the chimney. Someone brought weed into your middle school? That happened to... Let's see, was that middle school? I think that was middle school for us, too. There was a trip where we all went to a theme park one year. At my school. There's a theme park in Minnesota called Valley Fair. That's really great. And, we took a field trip to Valley Fair as just, like, a celebration one year. And a bunch of kids got caught smoking pot in the outhouses and got suspended for the rest of the year. They got suspended for the rest of the school year, but they didn't have to, like, do anything. They probably got in a lot of trouble with their parents and that kind of stuff. But, like... That's the punishment, though? They get suspended for the rest of the year, so they don't have to go to school for the rest of the year, but they still graduate? On time with everybody else? I mean, nowadays, I think, like, you know, school was fine, and so maybe go to school, sure, but... At the time, I just remember thinking, like, how is this punishment at all? To just have them not come to school, but then still graduate. But the thing is, though, again, I'm sure they all heard it from their parents, you know? Unless their parents gave them the pot. Let me think about who it was. Just no. The thing was, they were my friends. I didn't smoke pot. Well, I did sometimes, but I was not involved in the Valley Fair pot incident. But anyway. What was I saying? Oh yeah, I knew the kids, and they definitely didn't get it from their parents. Their parents were definitely all furious at them. A cat's costume from the musical. That's pretty cool, Jemima. Oh! One year, okay. So, at school, this wasn't, like, a Halloween costume, but there was a, punk day. Like, for homecoming week, there were, like, event days, you know, where every day there was, like, a theme for you to dress up as, and one day was punk day, and, I remember... trying to spike my hair, but it was a little bit too long for it to really work, so that was a bust. But I took a plain black t-shirt and took some masking tape and made a Casualties shirt. You know the band The Casualties? I've never listened to them, but I know that they're a punk band that my friend really liked. So I made a casualties shirt with masking tape, making the logo. And then I cut holes in socks to like put on my arms as like army glove things that were just old socks. I remember wrapping a belt around one of my arms and shutting it so I had a belt on my arm. And there were a few other things too. And people liked it. Everybody was like, Dash, except my name's not Dash, but they were like, Dash, you look pretty good in that punky outfit. And I was like, oh, shucks. Maybe it was just my friend who liked the casualties that said that. Spirit Week? Yeah, it was something like that. It was just homecoming week for us, but the idea. To get into school spirit. One of my favorite days was Get Up and Go Day, where you were just supposed to go to school in your pajamas. That was fun, because, I didn't, like, comb my hair or anything, so my hair was all crazy. And then you get to wear pajamas at school, it's great. Character Day. There might have been a Character Day also. Oh, right! I was talking about the Leon, that I was Leon for school, or for I was RE4 Leon for Halloween one year. And yeah, part of it was that a friend of mine had a really sweet leather jacket that was a lot like Leon's leather jacket. And that's kind of... That was an essential part of the costume. I was just thinking the other day that I might want to get a leather jacket again. I don't know. Well, I don't know. Maybe not. I go back and forth on whether I think I would look good in a leather jacket. Red versus Blue. I've seen very, very little Red versus Blue, but I hated it. I really don't like anything I've seen of Rooster Teeth. I've seen like a few Rooster Teeth things here and there, and I've always just, I'm not into their sense of humor and all that. I don't know. I don't like them. Yeah, the Mario crotch level is full of a bunch of big balls. Just like Flex said. Okay, here's the thing though. I also thought that I was really sick of, Egoraptor and Game Grumps and stuff. And I used to watch Game Grumps back when it was JonTron and Egoraptor and it first started, you know? And I liked it. But then I got sick of it, and didn't really watch it after that. However, Daisy showed me a Game Grumps video just the other day, or just, like, yesterday, and I liked it! It was entertaining! I liked it! So... You know. Maybe I'm wrong. I really like how this level looks. Ruby? I've heard of that. It looks... I don't know. I'm not... Eh. There's something about Ruby that just doesn't appeal to me at all. It's probably the fact that it has ties to Rooster Teeth, honestly. There's a phrase for what now? Absence makes... Oh, yes. Yeah, I mean, that's true. I used to be, like, really into Egoraptor in general. I loved all of his cartoons and other things that he did. I actually watched... Do you guys remember the reality show The Tester? It was the worst. It was like a Sony run reality show about people competing to be a video game tester for Sony. And season like 3 or something had Egoraptor on it. And I watched it until he was out. I watched the first, he was on like 3 or 4 episodes or something before he got kicked out. And let me tell you, this show was terrible. Oh man, it was like exactly as bad as you would expect an out-of-touch reality show about video games to be. Oofta. Oh yeah. Yeah, that's exactly what it was, Neener Wiener. Like, I really wonder, I would love to know the actual statistics of their viewer counts before and after he was on the show. Yeah, I mean, that's what they said the show was about. Really, the show was an advertisement for Sony games, you know? This week we're gonna play this upcoming Sony game. Look how cool it is. Oh, it was terrible, Red Panda. It was terrible. Yay, we're at the top of Mario Zone. It's Legos! I like to play Lego. Woo! What do you guys say? If you're going to engage in a family-friendly activity involving the product Lego or Legos, what would you say? Who are N and B? But what would you say? Just tell me that you are about to engage in some Lego playing. Just, I want to know how you construct the sentence. I'm very curious about this, okay? I don't care whether you're going to play with them or not. I just want to hear how you say it. And I'm trying not to say it myself because I don't want to influence the way that you say it. Or just tell me that as a child you enjoyed, passing the time with this particular toy product. That's not what I'm asking, Neener Wiener. I'm just asking you to tell me what you enjoy, the way that you said it. Call them Legos. Sure, but what did you say you were gonna do? Okay, Death Rider understands what I'm asking. Except that he says it like a crazy person. Okay, I remember this now. This was actually my favorite boss in the game. I love the idea of it and how it looks. Whoops. They were playing with their Lego? What? The children were playing with their Lego. Okay. I'm playing with my Legos. Alright. Okay. Very interesting. See, I say it like Kai does. I am going to play with Legos. I am going to play with Legos. Is what I would say. Now, I've heard people from Europe, mostly, say, I am going to play Lego. And I've... That is crazy sounding to me. Like Lego is the name of a game that you play. But no! You've got a product, here they are, they're Legos, and you're playing with them. That's how I always thought of it. Very interesting. Okay, I've had 999 coins forever, so we need to go do this. And then Crow is somewhere weird in the middle. 20 up, that's pretty sweet. Where you say play Legos, that's like both. You're pluralizing Legos, but then you're saying that you're playing Legos like Legos is a game. Lego is a word, you say? I mean, that changes things a little bit. Okay, here's the other thing I remember about this game. Is that the entire game is pretty easy, but then this level is pretty challenging. Oh, geez. Oh, I tried to duck under that while reading chat. I might have missed something that you said, Kai. I'm not following your train of thought exactly. Ninja, I only just heard of that person the other day. Ninja's like a family-friendly Fortnite streamer, right? Or something? Maybe not Fortnite, I don't know. But he's like a family-friendly, super popular streamer, right? Like one of the big guys? I've never heard of him, though. He has 100,000 viewers right now. That is insane. That is so many viewers. That is just absolutely crazy. No, it's fine, Crow. Oh, he used to be, so he's shaped up a bit. That's good to hear. But I mean, I don't know. It's not, from what I've heard, he doesn't sound like the kind of person that I would particularly spend my time watching. Nothing wrong with the stream that I know of, I've never seen it. I'm just saying that, like, you know. I've only got time to watch so many streams. That's not the kind of stream that I watch. However, if he's bringing enjoyment to 100,000 people, that's great! I would love to have... Oh! To shreds, you say? Did it. My Twitch dream. Honest, okay, all right. Let's talk numbers for a second as far as how I would feel. If I ever had 100 simultaneous viewers on Twitch, I would be happy with that for life. If I could get 100 viewers, I would love that. Not even that many, but what I'm saying is that would be like, I would feel like my Twitch career had been 100%... a success. I mean, it was a success already because it improved my life, but you know what I mean, though. I I guess that's as far as I'd go. I wouldn't turn down more viewers. Adam Sandler. That's kind of the thing, Kai. That's kind of where I was getting at, though. Is that right? Once you start to get too many, then it starts to be hard to keep up with chat and all that, and you start missing stuff and all that. All right. This level is a little bit more challenging than the others. So I gotta beat this level. So we can jump right over that, go under this thing, actually, oh no. Because those things line up that way, which hits me. Okay, so what I keep doing is waiting for this, and then jumping over it, and then that's getting me hit by that thing. But I feel like that's what I have to do. Amber! Oh my gosh, thank you. For the 40 bits and being my new best friend! Let's go. Okay, we did it. Okay, did I despawn? Did I just despawn a brick? No, it's this that I'm worried about. But this time they're on a different pattern. Did you see that? This time they're on a different pattern. But yeah, I agree though, Kitten Princess, that this part is, did I say hi to you, by the way? Hello! I like that you go right, then you go up, now you're going left. This level's really cool. I can get any song out of your head. Can I tell you guys? Well, okay, there's one song that I cannot get out of your head. Let me tell you the secret to getting any song out of your head, okay? Go on YouTube, or whatever music listening platform you prefer, but YouTube is fine because you get a music video, and watch the music video for the song, Revenge by Ministry. All right? And there you go. Ah! And now, it's not because the song Revenge by Ministry is, like, bad. In fact, it's great. It's one of my favorite songs of all time. I love that song. But it also just so happens to get stuck in your head so badly that it will get rid of any other song. And so that means that the only song that I cannot get out of your head is Revenge by Ministry. Well, it's nice of you to just say that, Kai. No! I feel like this shouldn't be so hard. Well, if you are tight on money, just know that I'm not tight on money. So, you know, don't worry about it. I stream as a hobby. I'm not trying to quit my job. You can duck under right there. Okay, that's good info. I still got hit, though. Yeah, if a song is stuck in my head, oftentimes if I just listen to the song once through, that helps. You had to save state this level? It's alright, I've got 34 lives. In times of rage, if you watch this stream, you just tell me anytime that you see rage. I don't rage at games. If you're looking for rage, you are in the wrong stream. My highest number of views at a time? I don't know. Probably, like 40, and that was after like a big host. As well. What up, Scott Looney? Oh, head over heels. Head over heels get stuck in your head. No, oh, I wasn't looking. I was reading chat. Disciple by Slayer. Okay, so I was saying that I didn't really like the album God Hates Us All by Slayer very much. I remember the song Disciple being the best song on it, though. I remember liking that song. Oh no, it's not chat's fault that I read chat. It's really weird that you can't duck jump in this game, because pressing down is what gets you to spin. So if, I just tried to demonstrate it. If you try to duck jump in this game, you just spin jump and it's weird. Okay, I'm gonna beat it this time, alright? Here we go. Did you see that expert slide to a stop? I didn't have as much momentum as I expected right there. Oh yeah, Crow, I watched that video you posted of Slayer's, like, intro. It was pretty sweet. I liked what they did there. I just love, you know, pentagrams and shit. Pentagrams and upside down crosses and skulls and, you know, all that kind of stuff. Just makes me happy. Okay, I don't know if I've ever been to this part big. Please don't zoom the camera down. I was only trying to duck under that fireball. Have I played Final Fantasy Type Zero? No, I have not. Mount that thing. I have played Final Fantasies 1 through 7, Tactics, a little bit of 13, and a little bit of 14. And I think that's it. Let me think a little longer. Oh, I've played Theatrhythm and Theatrhythm Curtain Call. Okay, this is what I failed last time. Yeah. I really like this room because it reminds me of Super Metroid, and I just really like when things remind me of Super Metroid. Ten's your favorite? I've heard a lot of praise of Ten. I'm definitely interested in it. I'm gonna play through 7 on... So 1 through 6 I played through on stream. And then 7 I've just played all my life. Well, since it came out. Okay, this is further than I've been. So we're going to do a Final Fantasy VII playthrough on stream at some point. And then I'm interested in playing 8 and 9 also. It wasn't that hard. Ooh! Yeah! Okay, you just run. Oops, I forgot about the Pringles man. Oops. Okay, we're gonna combo these guys. Yeah! There's two more! Okay. Oh. 13's your favorite and you feel great about it. Oh, 13. That's the only Final Fantasy that I've played and not liked. And I hated it. Whoops. Oh, we're going. We're moving right now. Look at what a doofus Wario looks like. Oh, geez. Hang on, what is even... Whoa. This does not control like it looks like it does. He's blinking for a long time. Is he dead? No. Okay. We get bunny power now. Okay, now he's bunny power. That was a great Game Boy laugh. That's as best as they could do with the Game Boy. Wait, are you serious? That was the boss? That was this part of the boss? Okay. Why did I pick that? Yeah, in 13, I got up to the part where the two ladies scissor into a motorcycle, and I was like, done! That was the stupidest thing I've ever seen, and not in a fun way. Yeah, it's pretty great, Kitten Princess. Like, and they do that a lot in Mario, in Mario, 3D World, there's the cat power, and then there's, like, the cat Goombas because of it, or Mario 3D Land, I think it is, has the Tanuki Goombas and stuff. That's a pretty good analogy, Scaploony. Or a good simile. I don't remember that, Neener Wiener. That might be fun to look up. That's something I should start doing. When I start a new game, I should try to find the advertisement for it and play it before starting. That would be a really fun idea. Oops. Well, we played through Mario Land 1 and 2. I'm not really sure what else to do. Whoa, Death Rider, I just saw your picture that you posted. Oh my god. That is so sweet. You told me about it one day, I think. You mentioned that it was the conspiracy makeup. That's so good. That's right, I was looking at Discord while streaming. Oh no, I understand, Crow. Nobody's judging. I think Wario is still pretty insane, right? He's a pretty crazy asshole. I better clip up this game before one of my boxes gets crushed. Okay, so Mario Land. Uh-oh. Okay, here's all the Mario Land stuff. Which side of this is up? Ah, there's a little 27 printed on it for some reason. What do we do next? I mean, I've got another hour or so to play video games. I don't know what to do with all that time. Play Mario? Let's play another Mario game. Which one? I'm kind of feeling some Mario 2. We could play Mario Land 3 Wario Land. It is 10:54 p.m. for me. We could, Neener Wiener. I have already played that one on stream. Yeah, let's play it. We're probably not going to beat it tonight because it's a little longer.